You are born in a miraculous system. You are not weak, you are strong. So there is a way that we can power up this innate immune system by using something as simple as fasting. Dr. Mindy here, and this video actually may be the most important video I've done the whole year of 2021. So those of you who've been asking me, how can you use fasting to fight an infection? How can you use fasting to prevent an infection, whether it's viral, bacterial, yeast? I'm gonna answer that on this video. And if you're new to my channel, I just wanna say welcome. I'm a woman on a mission to get 1 million people fasting. Fasting is our way out of chronic disease. Fasting is our path to being immune strong. So welcome, hit the notification and subscribe button so you get all the new videos and lives that I do. And those of you that share my videos out, so greatly appreciate you. Okay, fasting and infections. Now, I just want to point out, I've done videos on this. I cannot emphasize this enough. I am doing this video for you guys in September 2021. So I don't know when you're listening to it, but at September 2021, it is more important right now than ever that we have tools to improve what we call our innate immune system. So you have an immune system that will identify foreign invaders. And it's built around two different mechanisms. It has an innate immunity and an adaptive immunity. When a foreign invader comes into your body, whether it is a virus, bacteria, yeast, parasite, the initial immune system, this innate immune system, identifies it, tags it, and then sends it on to the adaptive immune system and says, hey, create an army for me that's going to attack this foreign invader. You are born in a miraculous system. You are not weak, you are strong. So there is a way that we can power up this innate immune system by using something as simple as fasting. So I'm just gonna use a virus as an example. You can decide what name of the virus you wanna put to it. That it could be flu, it could be the one we're all scared of right now, it could be Epstein-Barr virus, maybe it's chronic fatigue, same rule applies. So let's say a virus comes into your innate immune system and it's brand new. That innate immune system has never seen it before. So it is going to recognize it and create this immune response. Now you have two different energy systems that your cells are working off of. And we've gone through this. It is the sugar burner energy system and it is the fat burning energy system. So when that virus comes into the cells, it doesn't have its own energy system. It has to live off of yours. So if you are a sugar burner and a virus comes into the cell, it will gain energy and will replicate quicker because it loves sugar. Doesn't matter if it's the flu virus, doesn't matter if it's this virus we're all trying to get away from, doesn't matter if it's Epstein-Barr virus. If it comes into the cell, a sugar-burning cell, you give it energy and it will replicate more. This is why in the pandemic, if hopefully you know that the number one condition that will determine if you are gonna die from a virus or you are gonna recover quickly from a virus is metabolic syndrome. It is how much sugar is in the cell. If you have a high glucose level, you give that virus power. I can't emphasize that enough. Now, if the virus comes into the cell that's a fat burner, is in a place of state of autophagy, the immune system's recognizing it, trying to figure out what to do with it, you will literally shut viral replication down if your cells are in what we call a state of autophagy. Now, what's so fascinating about this current virus that we're all worried about, doesn't matter the variant, all that, there's 13 different variants at this moment, by the way. So let's get this under control because each variant, we're gonna need to use these same principles. So if a virus comes in, this current virus, it shuts down autophagy. This is why it can take over, because the virus is so smart that it's like, oop, I'm gonna shut autophagy down so that I can replicate much quicker. So that means we need to do more autophagy fasting, which is 17 hours to 72 hours, more of this style of fasting. And then with autophagy fasting, I have you break your fast with fat, and I have you keep your fat, your protein under 20 grams. This is important so that we keep these cells in a state of autophagy so you shut down replication. Now, what does this look like in action? So first, if somebody, you find out that you have been around somebody who tested positive for this virus, don't freak out. Just go into a state of autophagy. If you know you've been exposed, don't freak out. Just get your body in the state of autophagy so it doesn't replicate. Okay, what if you've been diagnosed with this virus? Don't freak out. Go into a state of autophagy. What if you're gonna go and get the shot and you don't want an adverse reaction? Don't freak out. Get in a state of autophagy. Right now, if the world was in a state of autophagy, we would stop viral replication. It literally is like your own internal, I'm not going to say the word because I don't want to get censored, but it is like your own internal, I don't know another name for it. It's like your own internal shot of powered up immunity, the V shot. It's the same as that when you're putting yourself in a state of autophagy. You are shutting down viral replication and you're improving your overall immune response. So, I can't emphasize this enough. I want this to get out into the world. Please share this with somebody. We can all point fingers at you should mask and you should go get the shot and you should quarantine, but that's not getting us anywhere as a human race. What's gonna get us out of this is when we point the finger back at ourselves and say, okay, I'm gonna bring down my sugar load. I'm gonna get in a state of autophagy. And that is gonna be a huge step forward in shutting down viral replication. That's where we all win as a human race. So, as always, let me know if you have a great experience using autophagy fasting around infections. If you like this information, I have more research, more videos that I did on this specific topic. One of my favorite ones that you guys liked is called The Most Dangerous Food You Can Eat for Your Immune System. If you want to see the research on this, you don't believe what I'm saying, I linked an article in the notes. If you want to bring this video to your doctor, you want to show your doctor, show them the science, because it was specifically autophagy and fasting on this virus. There are multiple studies already done. It's just that mainstream media isn't showing you it. So as always, I hope that helps. If you need more fasting help, join me in my academy. Just put Reset Academy in the comments and my team will send you a link. But as always, do not give up on yourself. Do not live in fear. You are more powerful than the world is telling you right now. Hope that helps.